She's real pretty.
You said you want the floor.
Okay, thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Kimbo's paying the floor. Can you hold, please?
Oh,
Steve, okay. Can you help me with these phones?
I'm sorry, you need to go, please.
Kimbo's paying the floor. Hello? Yes, thank you. Okay.
Michigan Sun's Kimbo's favorite florist.
Now you were saying. Flowers for a compassage.
Flowers for an entourage.
Flowers to the funeral home.
Leaving from St. Rome's Catholic Church at 9th and Vine.
$40 hold the line.
First thing in the morning, I'll be there in the morning.
Can you hold the rose bowl? He bought the rose bowl. You know the big inflated estimates we wrote for the rose bowl. Well, it's a rose bowl. Seems they want to buy our flowers here for every single float.
You can't keep the tournament waiting.
More sneak and throw. Schedule's favorite florist.
7,000 blue in-ears, carnations, all the yellow roses.
Please don't only got two ways, the left are two chrysanthemums.
Hollyhocks, a hearty cup, which one would you wait for?
Why are you waiting on? Sorry, so one minute and I'll get it for you.
Seymour, that reporter.
Her home is yesterday.
She wants another interview, said to bring the plan with you.
Audrey, it's a new account.
Sorry, that's the right amount.
Things is only coming white.
Sir, I'm too worn out to fight.
Sorry, those are out of stock.
Seymour, look. It's 6 o'clock.
Call back in the morning, will you?
Call back in the morning, won't you?
Call back in the morning, can you?
Call back in the morning, thank you.
Call back in the morning.
What a day, what a day. Seymour, do you mind locking up for me? I'm all in.
One minute, Audrey, I want to show you something. It won't take long. I've been shopping for a new wardrobe like you told me to, and, well, ta-da!
Oh, Seymour.
What, you don't like it?
I don't know,
I'll take it back. I'll take it back. I'll burn it. Just don't cry, please. Oh, look what I did. I only bought it to impress you. That's all I ever meant to do.
Oh, I don't know what's come over me. I guess I've just been a little under the weather lately.
It's alright, isn't it? Ever since his mysterious disappearance, you miss him.
Oh, miss him? I never felt so relieved as when they told me he'd vanished. It was like a miracle. Not to mention all the money I saved on aspirin and bandages.
Audrey, you have to waste one more minute of your time thinking about that creep. There's a lot of guys, nice guys, that'd give anything to go out with you.
Oh, I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
That's not true.
Well, you don't know the half of it. I've led a terrible life.
Audrey, don't.
I deserved a creep like Oren Scrivello. DDS. You know where I met him? In the gutter.
The gutter?
The gutter. It's a night spa. I worked there on my nights off when we weren't making much money. I put on cheap and tasteless outfits. Not nice ones like this one. Low and nasty apparel and I'd...
Audrey, that's all behind you now. You have nothing to be ashamed of. You're a very nice person, and I always knew you were. Underneath the bruises and the handcuffs, you know what I saw? Well, I respect it. I still do. Lift up your head. Wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me a face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup. Don't have to pretend. Suddenly see more. It's here to provide you sweet understanding. Daddy.
Don't you, Mr. Daddy, me, Trailborn.
Audrey, perhaps you'd like to go and... Excuse me, Seymour. How about you go and visit your dentist friend?
That's not very funny, Dad. You know he disappeared.
Oh, that's right. Isn't it?
What's he talking about, Seymour? What's he doing?
Why don't you run along like he asked, Audrey? I'll catch up with you later. I'll call you, if that's okay.
Of course it is. Good night, Seymour.
Little red dots, all over the floor.
You're acting pretty strange, Pop.
I had a pretty strange afternoon, son. After my lawyer's appointment, I was called to the police station.
The police?
Seems they made a routine investigation on the disappearance of Orange Gravello. And they found the Mushnick Skid Row florist bag in his office.
What's that supposed to mean?
Exactly what I asked myself, Seymour. But then I began to think about certain things that have been going on around here. The little red dots all over the floor.
I spilled some Hawaiian punch and it stained.
Ah, it's hard to keep things clean around here, isn't it? Especially when they only remove our garbage once a month.
What does that have to do with... Where are you going?
This is a dentist's uniform.
He's
got your number now.
I saw her last week, and I didn't think twice.
Knows just what you've done.
And the little red dot seemed innocent enough.
You got no place to hide.
And I kept you kissing the dentist girlfriend.
You got nowhere to run.
And it begins to look like a motive.
You know your life of crime. I think it's supper time.
I'm innocent.
Then how do you explain this?
Picture of a baseball cap?
Not just any baseball cap, Seymour. Your baseball cap.
I didn't do it.
Then come with me to the police and tell them there.
He's got his facts all straight.
Just so my conscience goes crispy.
You know he's on your tree.
If you don't come, I have to tell him myself.
He's gonna turn you in.
So are you gonna come?
They're gonna put you in jail.
Oh, oh okay.
He's USDA prime. For my supper time.
Deposit them in the morning.
You put them in the safe, didn't you?
No.
Why not?
I forgot the combination.
So where is it? There's thousands of dollars.
In the plan.
In the plan?
I thought that'd be the safest place. No thief would ever try and look there, right?
The money's in the plan? So how do I get in?
Sweet, sweet finger.
lover. And she will name me the editor's wife. We want a face on the cover of the December spread issue of Life. Yes, the front of Life magazine. That's a lot of research we want. We'll send someone down, let's say Thursday, such a view on your beautiful plant. Agency. Forget the cable we sent you. It's nice to meet me. The pleasure is yours. Well, I'm a firm representative. We want to book you on lecturing tours, college campus, rotary clubs. The kind of bookings my office can do. Show the plan, then talk, answer questions. It's educational luxury too.
My future's fine.
Busy.
Tough luck.
What's your attitude?
Grrrr!
Give me a break, will ya? I gotta finish my speech for the lecture and tour. It's all about you. Give me some peace and quiet, or I'll tell them the truth.
Don't get cute with me. I made you, and I can break you.
Go ahead. Break me. You think it's easy, living with the guilt?
Aw, cut the crap and bring on the meat!
Oh, if only you'd eat meat, if only you'd touch a mouse or flies. But no, you're so particular.
Aw, come on, Krillbon, feed me! I ain't it since Mushnik, and that was a week ago.
Look, how about I run down to the corner and get you a red roast beef? How does that sound?
And then you'll get me somebody?
Then I promise you'll never be hungry again.
Chow time, Krillbon. Food, food, food. Feed me food, food, food. Feed me food, food, food. I want food. Give me food.
Just shut up, William. I can't take it anymore. Stop swallowing. You're driving me crazy, for God's sake. Shut up, shut up, shut up, shut up. It's the matter with me. Don't you think I know it needs food? Don't you think I know it needs feeding? Don't you think I know I'm trying to think some way, something, someone?
Seymour, you're hysterical. What's the matter with a little plant food? I think running this place has got too much for you. When did Mr. Mushnik say he'd be back?
Huh?
You know, in that letter you told me he left you. For Walnut said he was going to his sister's house in...
Czechoslovakia. Right. He's going to be gone a very long time. Audrey, can I ask you a question?
Anything.
Well, just suppose for 1 minute that the Audrey 2 never existed, that I was a nobody again, and nothing. Would you, still like me?
I'd still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled.
Settled. A gun?
And rat poison, and a machete. Tomorrow morning, right after Life magazine takes a picture, you know who bites the dust.
Seymour.
Right, they'll snap a photo, we'll be famous. I'll take that television job, we'll live a nice, quiet, normal life. No more night feedings, no more squalling for blood.
Oh, what feedings? What blood? I don't get it, Seymour. The bullets, the knives, the rat poison? You're scaring me, Seymour.
Well, there's nothing to be scared about, Audrey. We'll move away from here. I'll take you to that nice little development you've always dreamed about. And we'll live happily ever after. I promise. Nice little house, nice little car, and no plans. No plans at all.
Oh, you're talking so peculiar, Seymour.
I'll explain everything tomorrow morning. Just go home now, Audrey. Please.
Well, I can't leave you in a state like this.
Don't worry about me. Don't worry about anything.
Feed me!
Under no circumstances.
Feed me!
Oh, no!
Feed me!
Okay, I can't take this much more. Right, I'll go down to the corner and get you a pound of rare roast beef.
No way!
Look, it's my last offer. Yes or no?
It's better than nothing.
Done! Fine. Great. And don't think you're getting dessert.
I couldn't sleep. I took a Somanex. But voices in my head kept saying, go to Seymour, talk to Seymour. I drank some tea, but gee, that feeling wasn't gone. Seymour, sweetheart, tell me, darling, what's been going on?
Hey, little lady, hello.
Who? Who said that?
You're looking cute as can be. You're looking mighty sweet.
Seymour!
No, it ain't Seymour. It's me!
Oh my God!
Your friendly Audrey too. This plant is talking to you.
I don't believe it.
Believe it, baby. It talks.
Am I dreaming this?
No, you ain't in Kansas, Neil.
Relax, go with it, doll. Do me a favor, will you, sweetheart?
A favor?
I need me some water, in the worst way. Look at my branch. I'm a goner, honey. Come on and give me a drink.
I think I should.
Hey, little lady, be nice.
Is that water, right?
Sure do I drink it straight.
I'm going to the dry poor thing.
Don't need no glass and no eyes.
Yes, I can.
Don't need no twist of life.
No.
And now it's supper time. I fed them to it.
And that's what made it so big and strong, and you so famous?
I've done terrible things, but not to you, never to you.
But I want you to, Seymour.
What?
When I die, which should be very shortly, lead me to the plant so it can live and bring you all the wonderful things you deserve.
You don't know what you're saying.
But I do. One gift I can give you. And if I'm in the plant, then I'm part of the plant. So in a way, we'll always be together. You'll wash my tender leaves. You'll smell my sweet perfume.
Enterprises, and we got a gilt-edged proposition for you, boy.
I'm not interested.
Let me explain in more detail. It's a very simple licensing deal. We take leaf cutters, develop little archery tools, and sell it to florists across the nation. Soon, every household in America will have one. If you don't mind, we'll start taking cuttings right away. Imagine, boy, archery tools everywhere. Why, with the right advertising, this could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops?
Much bigger!
every household in America, thousands of you, eating. That's what you've had in mind all along, isn't it?
Well, duh!
We're not talking about one hungry planet. We're talking about world conquest.
And I want to thank you!
You're a monster. So am I.
Feed me!
You ain't the only thing I ever loved.
Too bad!
Take that! Maybe it's tough on the outside, but in that pot, I'll pack your dick. I'll get it on the inside. Open up! Open up! Open up! No! Mr. Krellborn? Mr. Krellborn? Okay, girls, start cutting some of the smaller leaves and replant them in these pots. The truck's waiting outside. Open the van, boys! We're ready to start loading!
Events you have just witnessed. Similar events in cities across America. Events which bore a striking resemblance to the ones you have just seen began occurring. Oh, 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 oh. Subsequent to the events you have just witnessed. Unsuspecting jokes from
fighting chaps who would feed them their fears. she sings. The 6 o'clock alarm will never ring. What's it like?